I'm Shane Jolley and welcome to Luxury Escapes, a new television series that takes viewers on a journey to the world's best holidays. Some holiday destinations just sell themselves, and this is no exception. With its palm-studded beaches, untouched rainforest, tropical climate, and of course, the stunning Great Barrier Reef. This is a luxury traveller's paradise, and one of the world's best holidays. Here we are, Port Douglas.
Far North Queensland is a hive for travellers from all over the world, seeking sun, sand, and scenery. Is so favoured, the population doubles during the summer months. My luxury escape begins in Port Douglas, and then I'm heading south to the picturesque Palm Cove, which is renowned for its beautiful beaches and world-class resorts. Apart from its laid-back atmosphere, Far North Queensland is the gateway to the heritage-listed Great Barrier Reef. My adventure here begins with a chopper ride with GBR helicopters and trusty pilot, Matt.
So where are we actually landing, Matt?
We'll head out to the reef here first. We'll have a bit of a look around to Low Isles and Bat Reef. Bat Reef, it's the closest reef to the coastline in this area. And then we'll head back in towards the rainforest. We'll follow the Dane Tree up and find a little spot just in the rainforest canopy. We'll descend beneath the canopy to a beautiful little waterfall up in the hills up there. And I'll show you guys around up there.
And I'm guessing you'd see a fair bit of marine life down there?
Yeah, you're bound to see quite a few rays, turtles. You see the odd dugong out here occasionally, particularly in the winter months. You'll see the crocodiles out enjoying the afternoon sun.
That doesn't sound so good.
Yeah, I prefer to see them from about 500 feet. That's about as close as I like to get.
When moving from the reef to the Dane Tree, the weather and scenery change is almost immediate.
So Matt, where are we flying into now?
Stewart's Creek, it's called. It's a catchment area that comes down one of the ranges just out to the west here. You'll see where we go into that it's pretty inaccessible to anyone except unless you're in a helicopter. Once you're in there, you feel like you're on another planet pretty much. And there's a nice clearing, a rock clearing right beside the waterfall. It's obviously a massive catchment area, so at different times that water level can get right up. The rock area you can see to the left there, that's where we've been putting it down.
That is incredible.
Having two beautiful locations so close to each other makes for an unforgettable experience.
It feels like you're in a different world, you know?
It really does. It feels like something out of Jurassic Park, I have to say, when we're coming in landing. It's incredible.
And that reaction's not uncommon.
Yeah.
Jurassic Park is quite often what I hear.
It's awesome, mate. I just think it'd be a great place for a little picnic up here, wouldn't it?
Yeah, we quite often bring food and drink for people up here, set them up for a few hours. They can have a swim there. Obviously, the water's nice and chilly. Perfect for a Cairns hot summer's day.
Yeah, I'm absolutely loving it down here. I don't want to leave this place, I have to say, but we're almost due back, aren't we?
Have a little bit more of a look around, enjoy yourself.
Great.
I'll get things sorted and we can depart at your leisure. We'll have a look at a couple more waterfalls on the way back there and maybe a peek at the Mossman Gorge and then descend into Port Douglas.
Sounds great, mate.
As well as getting above the water, it's a must in Port Douglas to get on it. Well, I've been to Port Douglas, but I don't think I've ever been sailing like this before. So, really looking forward to it. Let's go and check it out. I'm lucky enough to be on the Aquarius Port Douglas Cruises 62-foot cat. This fabulous vessel provides sunset cruises around Dixon Inlet and offers their guests great food and drinks and, of course, great views.
So, how long have you been doing this, Andy?
A couple of days.
A couple of days, right. Fantastic.
No, 17 years.
Right, 17 years. Yeah, and you're doing it one-handed as well.
Evening.
That's just showing off. Far out.
I'll teach you, you'll be right.
Yeah. Well, I might have a go a bit later on, that's all right.
Yeah, too easy.
Andy was true to his word, and after a short while of learning the ropes, I was handed the wheel. Once the inlet is navigated, you're out in the Pacific and are treated to views of the Dane Tree on shore and a stunning sunset out to sea. The cat caters for up to 45 people, so you're sure to meet some fellow travellers. This fantastic and relaxing cruise capped off a great day for me in Port Douglas. And along with a beautiful sunset, I've got some great memories to take home with me. Coming up, I visit the incredible Palm Cove and discover the wonders of Adelaide. For my next luxury escape, I'm taking a short drive south to the magnificent Palm Cove. I've been here many times and love the fact that this sleepy village by the sea is home to fantastic beaches and some world-class resorts. And this time round, I'm lucky enough to be staying at the best, Pepper's Palm Cove. Amongst its many features, the resort boasts a huge beach-style swimming pool that includes a swim-up bar, as well as a fantastic restaurant, the Lime and Pepper. Thomas is the head chef, and his out-of-the-box thinking and style makes for creatively delicious dining.
I think if you only use one cooking technique or from one part of the country or the world, it's a little bit boring.
Yeah.
So we really try to be a little bit different, thinking outside the square. Years ago, I had accidentally some rosemary on my finger and tried it with a lemon sorbet, and it was such a flavor sensation, this rosemary with a lemon together.
And what's so unique, do you think, about the Pepper's restaurant here compared to, you know, other destinations that you've worked at?
It's the environment. We have three pools at the Pepper's resort. One we are standing at the moment, it's a Serenity pool.
Amazing pool.
This pool area we also use for weddings. It's a great area to have a barbecue in the tropics. You have the open barbecue char grill, people sitting here in the area with some tables, and you have this tropical feeling. Then we have our big beach pool with the children and family loves it, with the sandy beaches, walking into the water. It's sensational.
Amazing.
You have the restaurant in the front, you have the amazing entry. When you come to the lobby, you walk straight to the waterfall, to the pool areas. It's a great area to work.
I'm sure as a chef you would have a particular signature dish.
Oh, I have a couple of signature dishes.
Okay.
One of them we have straight in front of you. So it's Aperol cured ocean trout with some finger lime pearls, homemade dukka, and a wakame seaweed salad. And a nice line of a Davidson plum.
Fantastic. Well, I might actually try one of those, Thomas, if you don't mind.
Take it. Take the big fork, your fingers, and take it.
Okay.
That's great.
All right, there we go. Oh, wow. How tender is this? That was amazing, Thomas.
Mm. Something really fresh.
That is amazing.
The indulgence at Pepper's doesn't end at their dining experiences. Pepper's offers guests a fabulous spa treatment that utilises the surrounding rainforest for inspiration.
Well, today I'm getting the Daintree Rainforest Ritual. It's the signature treatment here, using native salts, clay, ochre, and other ingredients unique to this area. I can't wait.
Basically, it's a beautiful process that we start with coating you with warm oil on the Vichy shower, sprinkling desert salts that you get to choose by touch and sensation.
Oh, nice.
Really high in magnesium, so really nutrient rich for you. And then we have a selection of three different muds that we source locally from the iconic Daintree Rainforest up here. So
right.
It's really, really nice to bring the outside energies into our spa here, which is pretty, pretty amazing.
Yeah.
So it's basically going to take you on a sensory journey that your body will choose.
And how do you choose the muds? Like, what's the, you know, the basis behind that?
So what appeals to your sight is what your body's going to tell you that you need. So one's purifying, one's nutrifying, one's cleansing and detoxing.
Right.
So, you know, you'll know by the end what your body needs.
Perfect.
As I said, all of the muds are selected from the iconic Daintree rainforest. Yeah.
And why would you get them from the Daintree? What's the
reason? Well, this is where
that?
We are. We're up in the Daintree,
right,
you know.
Right.
And we've got 40 million years of rainforest there, and this beautiful story and the energies and everything that go with it. So why not harness them and get people from all over the world to experience that holy and solely with us at the spa.
Yeah, makes sense.
Oh, this feels absolutely amazing.
If you want to stay at the best resorts in the world, visit luxuryescapes.com or text Palm Cove to 0476 857 406. Coming up, I sample the vine and sophisticated style in Adelaide.
This place is known as the 20-minute city because its picturesque CBD is only a stone's throw away from scenic drives through to world-class food and wine precincts, as well as dynamic arts and entertainment opportunities. This is Adelaide.
There is plenty of shopping, cafes, restaurants and parklands, all within walking distance of the city centre. Taking a morning stroll down the wide streets of North Terrace and looking at the magnificent monuments and beautiful architecture is a great way to start the day in Adelaide. My walk has taken me to Adelaide's Botanical Gardens. The gardens cover an impressive 125 acres and are home to both the largest and oldest glasshouses in the Southern Hemisphere. John, the resident botanist, showed me around the iconic Palm House.
And we've now filled it with wonderful plants from Madagascar, some really diverse forms. They're succulents. They're anywhere in the world you wanted to take somewhere to show different types of plants that, and make them think they're on another planet, it would be probably the southwest of Madagascar.
Right.
Over the years, areas have been added to make the gardens one of Adelaide's showpiece attractions. And architect Guy Moron is proud of his contribution.
Adelaide is such a beautiful city. There's so much to see and do.
Indeed it is, and it's a very compact city. And right in the middle we have this magnificent botanic garden.
Yeah.
Enjoying about 1 million visitors a year. This is therefore the greatest attraction in South Australia and in Adelaide.
One of the garden's most beautiful additions was constructed to celebrate Adelaide's bicentenary, the multi-award-winning Bicentennial Conservatory. And Guy's passion for both architecture and horticulture made this one of his favourite projects.
Tropical rainforests have special conditions and special requirements.
Right.
And this building really encapsulates that. And so this is a slice through a rainforest, right?
Amazing.
And what plants need? They need light. They need humidity, water and nutrition. And you really can only achieve this ecosystem if you have this volume.
Well, Guy, I have to ask you about this incredible looking roof.
Well, one of the requirements of an ecosystem of a forest is to be able to grow trees that are 20 meters tall.
Right.
That is the biggest assembly of glass that each strass ever lifted anywhere in the world.
Amazing.
Yeah. But the important thing about conservatives is plants. And what we're trying to do is to bring man closer to plants. Yeah, it's been a really good thing for South Australia, a good thing for Adelaide, and a good thing for science as well.
A short drive from the CBD takes you to Adelaide's world-renowned wineries. There are many fantastic vineyards dotted all over Adelaide, but there is one in particular that I've heard is one of its best. Established for over 100 years, Darrenberg's is a family-run business, and I'm meeting the owner, Chester, and I'm told he has as much character as the wine he produces.
Well, Clarenvale's really special because it's right on the coast,
yeah.
Which gives a really Mediterranean climate. So you don't get too hot a days, and but you still get some nice cool weather at night. So it's great for viticulture because you want a little bit of that daily variation to get the fragrance and floweriness in the wine.
Sure.
But not really hot,
yeah.
Because the heat will cook the grapes and burn some of the characters out of them. There's the oldest vines in the world of Shiraz and Mourvedre and Grenache,
sure.
And Chardonnay are in Australia. There's a really unique character that you get in the South Australian wines that people, once they get a thirst for it, they just have to keep coming back to it. So that's really what's so special as far as quality of grapes.
Sure.
But as a lifestyle, we're half an hour from Adelaide.
Yeah.
We're right on the beaches here. Yeah. So, yeah, it's got everything.
Perfect location.
We should have a drink.
Oh, I think if that's okay, that'd be terrific.
I can't really have a glass this empty for this long. You know what that's called? Cenosilicophobia. The fear of an empty glass.
Is that right? I was suffering that a minute ago. There you go.
Exactly. Yeah, cheers.
Cheers, yeah, absolutely.
The cellar door experience has become hugely popular in Australia, and Darry's cellar door and restaurant offers the luxury traveller a food and wine premium indulgence. Peter, Darrenberg's head chef, has been combining food and wine for years and introduced me to his latest coupling.
So we've got some beautiful Kangaroo Island oysters that I've put onto a little bit of salt mixed with some egg white,
right.
So it holds it and sits in there quite nicely. Last minute, little bit of smoking.
Yeah.
Just to give it a flavour, under a cartouche or under some glad wrap, and this will actually tie in really well with our Chardonnay here. I don't want a strong smoke on it.
Right.
So the apple wood is a little bit more aromatic and gentle.
Right.
A little bit of the wakame seaweed salad,
yes,
that I've got here.
Yes.
Now we've got some wasabi flying fish roe.
Right.
Just sort of popped in the mouth.
Yeah, beautiful.
Awesome. And then I've got a little dressing here, sesame oil, kimchi powder,
wow,
soy sauce, and then we'll fire up.
Okay.
turn it on the back.
Oh, yeah. Very easy to use, isn't it?
So probably a couple of minutes.
Couple of minutes.
In a restaurant situation, it's really quite good because you can lift off the cartouche, a bit of smoke, as you can see. Good bit of theatre in the restaurant.
Yeah, totally.
Try an oyster.
I was hoping you'd say that.
It's not just the food and wine that are fantastic at Darrenburg's. The hills and dales that make up McLaren Vale region are the perfect setting to sample a peppery Shiraz or tangy Riesling. And my guide, Rachel, knew just the spot to enjoy one.
And what's the name of the vineyard that we're going to now?
We actually call the vineyard the Bamboo Scrub. So we do have a Shiraz that we call the Bamboo Scrub from that area.
Right.
But my favourite vineyard there is the Blind Tiger. That was planted back in 1926. So there's something special about touching the vine and drinking the wine.
This view, Rachel, is absolutely phenomenal.
I know, it's gorgeous, isn't
oh.
it?
It's amazing.
I love coming up here. We do actually get sheep coming up here to basically mow the vineyards so that we don't actually have to use any fertiliser.
The sheep have certainly got a good here. And no matter what time of the year you visit McLaren Vale, it's always stunning.
Our wines, I say, choose what you want to have to drink at breakfast time, open it up, put it in the decanter, and by the time you come home from work, it'll be perfect.
Ready to go. Yes. Cheers, absolutely.
Coming up, I take a night out on the town in Adelaide. For my Adelaide luxury escape, I'm staying at the fantastic Mayfair Hotel. The Mayfair has been standing proudly since 1873 and combines old-fashioned service and style with modern conveniences that gives it a charm all of its own. The boutique rooms here offer custom-made beds that are so popular with visitors, the hotel now sells them as a range. After a wonderful day in the wineries, sampling some of Adelaide's nightlife is a must. If you get the chance to stay at the Mayfair, a couple of their big draw cards are definitely the restaurant and bar. The Mayflower a la carte menu offers delicious mains, and head chef Bethany Finn has taken her menu to the good old days.
The Chateaubriand was really a celebration of yesteryear, coming out of wartime, and it was all Great Gatsby and Belle Epoque.
Great.
And it was really to celebrate the luxury, because it had been a hard time
yeah,
back then.
Yeah.
And so really the Chateaubriand was the centre cut of the fillet, which is the best piece, and it's served with a bouquetière of vegetables. This fillet, look at that, medium red.
Perfect. Perfect.
And you have to have a little of the Bernays as well.
Oh, fantastic. Wow, thank you so much.
Okay, so for dessert.
Yes.
This is our lovely retro glamour dessert trolley.
Love it.
My personal favourite.
Yes.
Well, I've got two, is the Chou Swan and the Beehive.
Does that mean I get both?
Yes.
Fantastic. Would love it.
Indulge.
I will, don't worry. You don't have to ask me twice.
The elegance doesn't stop at the dinner plate at the Mayfair. The chic and relaxed Hennessy bar on the hotel's rooftop is the perfect place to watch the city below and is popular with guests and locals alike.
Named after the architects, Hennessy and Hennessy, father and son.
Yeah.
We wanted to have a connection to the past, but also showing we're a venue that embraces the future.
Yeah.
To give our guests a bar experience as well as the restaurant and other things, but also just get the local community in celebrating a rooftop bar, and everyone loves a rooftop bar. We wanted to be the place when we opened the hotel where everyone just comes to meet. I don't really care if they're not staying here,
yeah.
Essentially. We just want people to see it as a meeting place.
If you want to stay at the best hotels in Adelaide, visit luxuryescapes.com or text Adelaide to 0476 857 406. The emerging small bar scene in Adelaide has produced some great venues. Mr. Good Bar is situated in the hospitality precinct of Rundle Street on the east side of the CBD, and its mixed contemporary interior design and classic cocktails have made it a hit with both locals and travellers.
So there was a lot of planning that went into it in the design. You know,
sure.
So when you come through the front door and up the stairs, like, it all sort of ties in.
Yeah, yeah. Which it does.
That was the plan,
absolutely
yeah.
does.
I think we're really lucky in Adelaide at the moment because our local government have been really supportive, you know, and they initiated, you know, the idea to bring vibrancy into
yeah.
the city. And
sure.
that's how the whole bar scene's really come alive,
yeah.
and it's worked so well.
Now, Goran, if we were to do a cocktail that's inspired by the world's best holidays, what would it be?
I was lucky enough to visit Cuba a few years ago.
Right.
And I got to taste some amazing rums. And I think Kate's making one at the moment. It's called the El Presidente.
So what have we got happening here, Kate?
So this is an El Presidente cocktail. It's a Cuban Prohibition era cocktail. It was a bunch of American bartenders who went over to Cuba and created some really fantastic drinks. So this one is 40 mils of Cubani spiced rum. We've also got 20 mils of sweet vermouth.
Is this a summer inspired drink? Generally speaking,
I mean, it's more of a grown-up's holiday cocktail, I think. So there's 10 mils of dry curacao in that one, and then we're just going to add 5 mils of raspberry syrup into that one as well, just to sort of round it out. And then we stir this cocktail.
Fantastic.
The final touch, a little bit of citrus rind.
That's great.
Squeeze that over, get some of the oils.
Wow.
And there we go.
And there it is. Wrap your lips around that, mate. Go on.
Both Adelaide and Port Douglas offer so many wonderful experiences, from unchanged natural wilderness to up-to-the-minute entertainment trends, and are both great luxury escapes.
Thanks for watching. I hope you can join me next time to see more of the world's best holidays on Luxury Escapes.
Next week, we visit the enchanting Thailand, enjoy the sun in Koh Samui, and the nightlife in Bangkok.